Why we struggle to study? How to inspire your brain to study effortlessly? Is it because of the lack of motivation? Or by unfamiliarity with the pages? Or we don't know what is important to study? We are going to explain a three-step learning principle based on the three Hollywood icons. Motivation from the man of sheer focus, John Wick. Familiarity from the most immersive director, Christopher Nolan. And importance from Nicolas Cage, the man who got unbearable propensity to hunt for treasures. Let's get started. This method actually combines the six influential books on studying as well as my journey through engineering and MBA and a 24 of certifications and all coined around these three principles of motivation, familiarity, and importance. By end of this video, you will have some way like a fresh perspective on how to make the study easier and make it more enjoyable. Step number one, find your motivation. Yes, inspired from John Wick. So like the drive of John Wick doing a revenge, because he got a purpose. Okay, he is getting revenge for his dog as well as his car, to make it simple. So similar way, without any purpose, okay, you're just reading a book. Even if you read 1,000 times, it will be just a waste of effort. With a clear purpose, a single reading of a book is sufficient. And that is actually not, you're not forcing yourself to learn. Instead, you should be stay calm with you and the process will unfold naturally. So how to do it? First of all, reflect on your purpose. Why you want to learn a particular book? Natural reasons could be passing an exam or make your parents or teachers happy or avoid the shame of failure in front of your friends. Anything. It should be more clear and concise. That's important. That purpose, keep it in your mind, then go on further. After that, visualize and have an intention setting. Yes, it's something like you are praying for yourself, but it will be more logical this time. In the sense, like you close your eyes, spine straight, then you just have a deep breath of yourself, and then let your inner being, your core, is relaxed. That's the idea here. Then you revisit that purpose which you mentioned, that intention. Intention have a greatest power. So in that way, you are some way in a God's mode. Okay, now after you have a purpose, you make your intention set. Now you have a book in your hand. Don't be serious this time. Just flip through the books. Look at the front page, back page, table of contents. And even the headings, if you want, just read it like you are reading a magazine. Just skim through the book. After skimming through all the books and all, you will have some idea about what this book is all about. And you have a purpose also. Declare your goals, or in another way to put it simply, write your purpose to yourself. Okay, I want to learn this book for this purpose and I am expecting to learn these things. One way, this declaration will help your brain to have an understanding about what to focus on this learning process. Like John Wick, he's a person of sheer focus.
John is a man of focus, commitment, sheer will, something you know very little about.
Step two is achieving familiarity with ultra-fast reading, inspired by Christopher Nolan. The way we know how to learn from school is actually flawed. So that's one of the main reasons we hate books also. So suppose, imagine, you're going to a new location using your car. You're driving. You will be very much stressed. You will be worried about whether you will reach on time, whether you will just misguide yourself. But second time, you go to the same place, you don't have to even think about it. Your legs and wheels will take you there. So that's the magic of familiarity. The idea here is to be familiar with the content you are studying. Then the learning process will be like deja vu. So how to do it? First of all, you have to understand the fundamentals. Because Elon Musk famously told that the learning is something like you're building your tree. You should have your trunks first, then the branches and all these things. Before learning anything, you should have some level of basic fundamental understanding of the concepts. One way to look at it is to find the ways. Maybe you could revisit your notes which you've taken from your college or something. But if that is not at all available or it's very stressful, one way to look at it is look at the glossaries. At the end of the book, it will have a definitions of the key topics or index is there at the end. That could be one option to look at it. Just try to see what is this all about. Try to understand it in the shortest way, the fundamental understanding of that topic. That will is the first step to be familiar with the topic you are studying. So now having familiarity, now the process is the hardest one, reading. Imagine you are having a camera, like Christopher Nolan having a camera, he's just capturing everything. Similar way, read the book. Instead of reading the words or sentences, take the photograph of that. So the idea here is that you will just flip the pages at 1 to 2 seconds per page like that. This is actually photo reading technique proposed by Paul Sheely. The idea here is that your subconscious brain is capable to manage high amount of data compared to your normal brain. You have a limitation of reading when you are normally reading and understanding a particular words and all. So idea here is to have a full look on that book and then flipping through the pages. So you have a full view about the corner of the book. That's simply photo reading, is it? Like that, just go through all the pages. You take the snap of all the book one by one, but don't worry about it. Don't try to read it also. Don't try to read the sentences. Don't worry. With the right purpose, motivation, and familiarity, your brain already knows what to read and it will read itself. Somehow rely on that magic rather than the logic. So after doing that, okay, after just photo reading the book, you have to actually close the book, then sleep on it. Ideally, it should be 24 hours or a day. So the idea behind here, the logic here is to allow the brain to have an enough time to digest and process and organize that particular information so that now again you revisit that. In photo reading, they call it activating. The brain will have everything organized because now you have already set a purpose. You already familiarize your topic, you learn the fundamental, and you give the data to the brain. Now the immense potential brain, allow it to have its time to organize during your sleep. Step 3, identify what is important, inspired by Nicolas Cage, National Treasure. So the point is that learning becomes so boring, so cramming and cracks to your brain because somehow you are struggling first of all to understand what is important and try to understand what that concept is. But here, as we follow through the 2 steps before, you have a greater advantage here. Still, you can read like your normal book, but now you are doing more of an active learning than passive learning. Now you have understand the purpose, you have clear idea of what is there, and then you will go further. So we'll see how to do it, don't worry. But now you are more into an active way of learning, but more a productive way of doing it. First way is to read the questions. Because people usually used to tell that easiest ways to pass an exam is to look at the past year question papers and all. Even if that question is not going to repeat, that will give you a flavor of what are the questions the examination board want you to learn. So that way you can focus on that. Or some way it is not like you are competing with the examination board. Instead, just understand their motive and you are helping them to win along with them. If you cannot get past year question paper, at least there will be a lot of question banks nowadays. Even if that is also not available, most cases you will get that. At least you can look at the questions at the end of the chapter, which most of the textbooks, especially college and school textbooks, will have it. So just try to read it and understand it. What are the questions the author want you to understand? And what are the questions the examination board, your teacher want to understand? That will give you a good understanding about what to hunt for. You are into a treasure hunting now, like Nicolas Cage, but you want to know what you are hunting for. That's important. Now at this stage, you will start reading like you read in any way, normal way before. Don't push too much on the speed of reading. Be relaxed and read it slowly, but read it in such a way that you have a zoomed view like an eagle. Then only when you find something, you will dive into it, like an eagle hunting for its prey like that. But don't worry, you should trust your intuition. As we already go through the process before, Your brain, your subconscious mind, everybody already know that what is important. So you have to somehow trust your intuition and then read it. So reading through it, just read maybe one page, you look at it, you'll not see anything. Second page, you look at it, you can either look at the headings or you can start reading the first line of the paragraph. Maybe that's the thing. Or sometime you will just catch your attention on one particular word. Then you can read that whole sentence and then you can read that whole paragraph. Then a paragraph afterwards, like that you can go on. Once you lose that focus or that drive, hunting drive on a particular topic, just proceed further. As you already have your questions there, your mind will try to get the answers to that questions while you are reading that. So that way, it will be more productive way of learning. Even in a single read, you will be just learning everything what you are supposed to learn. Now, especially most people make notes. Notes is actually a very powerful technique, but people actually do it over. And they try to note everything what is in the textbook and the same way what is mentioned in the textbook, which is wrong. Instead, you understand the topic, you can use two methods. One is Feynman. Richard Feynman used to be very famous for simplifying the complex topic in his own way. They call it Feynman technique and all. So try to reflect that concept in your own way, then write the notes. That one way to look at it. Another way to look at it is protege effect. Okay, suppose you learned this today. Tomorrow, before the exam, your friend come and ask you, what is this about? Then you are going to tell that to him in a very shortest possible sentence because exam you are going to enter the examination room. So that simplified explanation, that's also very helpful. You can note that. Don't worry, that will give you the whole picture. If you give that clue of treasure hunting, that whole story of the treasure hunt, it will come to your mind. So don't worry about that. So that way you can simplify your note taking and you can reduce your effort in making the notes as well. After reading the whole book, you have gone through all the questions and you are hunted through all the answers from the book. Everything is there. And you already made the notes in your own understanding and in your own explanation. You already put it there in the book, in the notebook. Now, one way what you can do is to make it more brain-friendly by diagrammatically presenting it. A picture is equivalent to 1,000 words. So, one way to use it is the mind maps. It doesn't necessary to be a tool. There are a lot of tools available online. If you cannot find something, you can comment in the box. I can tell you a lot of options. Don't worry about that. If you don't have such access to such things, electronic gadgets or something, you can even make it in your own notebook, some diagrammatic way, a central topic. A mind map is something like a central topic and it will have branches like neurons. You're representing it. So the diagrammatic thing, before you exam, before going to your exam, if you look at that, it will give you a complete picture of what this topic is all about. That somehow the three-step process of learning. In all the book available, you don't have to learn everything sentence. You are not a scanning machine or a copying machine or a computer or something. You only want to learn what you are supposed to learn. And that way, this final method of understanding what is important will help you to learn such things. So the why, the purpose, the how, the familiarity, and the what is important, is the three step to learn anything. That's somehow the conclusion. Also, along with that, you can explore the six books we listed in this summary, already listed in the description as well. You can go through this at your convenient time and you can go in deep on each of this topic. We referred all the six books and we make our own version of that. But when you read it, I'm sure you will find your own version of doing that as well. Until then, bye for now.